Hey folks, it's Jang here on an uncharacteristically dark and rainy and loud California afternoon. I have to apologize if you hear the noise of rain in the background. Hopefully it's not going to be too distracting. I'm going to have to talk a little bit louder than normal, but I'm here with an uncharacteristically large Lego City set. This was set number 7994. It was called Lego City Harbor. It was released in 2007 and it was on the market through the end, roughly the end of 2008. So this one has been discontinued, but you can still find some of them out there on eBay, mostly used ones. When it was new, it was sold for $90 US, and I got this one used from eBay. Had to pay a little bit more than the original retail price, but fortunately it came pretty complete and everything is in pretty good shape. So I've just reassembled everything to factory specs the way that the instructions say to build it up. And this is, I believe, the single longest hull of boat or ship that LEGO has ever released in system or minifig scale. It's about 2 feet long, so enormous. You can just see the little minifigs here, and I'll just put one on there, directly on there, just for a little bit better scale. This is a very, very big boat. It has a unitary hull, so it's all one piece. On the outside, all the blue that you see is one piece, and it does actually float. So you can play with this in a pool, hopefully a pool that doesn't have too much disruption to the surface, because you still can kind of tip it over. You can splash water into it, or in a very large bathtub. Emphasis on very large for a bathtub. I really don't know if it's the best thing to play with in a bathtub unless there is no kid in there with it. Regardless, here we go. Let's take a look at the components that come with this set. First off, minifigures, of course. I'm going to start with the captain. He's the captain of the ship. You can see he's got that nice ship captain button-up shirt with a nice little bit of collar detail on it, and he's got the anchor detail on his one pocket. This is just an operator for the big crane that we saw in the background. He's pretty normal and he uses pretty standard stuff, head and cap and, well, everything about him you've seen in other city sets, especially from around that time. This guy here is a dock worker, just a general guy to help out with, you know, loading, unloading stuff and maintenance and everything. And then we have also one more pretty normal, pretty regular minifigure, just another worker dude. He probably will be doubling as a driver for the truck, and we'll see the truck that's included with this set pretty soon. And then finally, you also have a fisherman. He's just a regular guy who, I don't know if he's an employee of the harbor or not, but he's just out there. He's got a quite an impressive fishing pole with a pretty long string on it and a little bobber attached to the end of that also. So that takes care of the minifigures, and again, you can see that they're just dwarfed by everything else that's included here. Let me move them off to the side for the time being. I had this guy off over here fishing off the edge of the pier. The next largest component of the set would be this truck here. That's a pretty good looking medium duty truck, not extra heavy duty. You know, the cab is fairly low. They've got nice little step detail that they added in on the sides. Fenders on the front, pretty low side view mirrors. It's a little bit odd, but in general, a pretty decent looking truck, and it's a container carrier. So it's a light duty or medium duty container carrier. This comes off. You can see it wasn't even attached by any studs. It's just placed in place, and you can actually use the crane to offload containers from the from the boat onto the truck, or you can haul stuff in from other parts of your city from the truck, put them onto the boat. This does not have any opening doors, but you can see it has a little bit of texture to the outside with the use of these panels that kind of inset the insides there, and it's completely hollow inside. To put stuff in, you have to actually remove one of the panels. They don't have any actual opening, you know, doors or panels that are intended to be easy to swing apart. You actually have to take something off. But that takes care of that little guy. I'm going to move him off to the side. And now, since this big old boat is in the way, I guess I'll just talk about it, since it is kind of the main focus of this set. It's the main thing that you see. Well, it's between it and the crane. Most of this is kind of prefab, you know, the whole blue section, like I say, it's unitary. It's just one single piece of plastic. And then I'm actually going to take these out for the moment, just so you can see a little bit more of the shape of the boat on the inside. You can see that's all pre-molded for the most part. You got a couple little things added in there, but most of that is just its own shape, one big piece that you can take out. If you do get water kind of down the edges here, you can take this entire center piece out. The gray comes out as one piece. Let's take a look at the superstructure. Pretty nice looking superstructure back here. It's got kind of two levels to it. You can see a lower level down here, and I'll show you what's going on inside there in a minute. But then you've got this upper level, which looks even better. It's got a little bit of observation deck area on the sides. You've got a little radar dish. You've got a nice funnel style smokestack, you know, exhaust stack. Got a little, to me that looks like another radar thing. That's actually an interesting piece. This has only been used in a couple of sets. It's originally from the Scala series, but I believe this has only been used in a couple of sets, and I believe this is the only set that's used that piece in white. So a pretty rare piece to use there, but it does fit with the standard system stuff. And as I turn this around, just so you can see from the back a little bit of texture on the back there, more windows down there, a little bit of a ladder design there. And then let me open this top up. You can see it comes up pretty easily. It's just connected by these two studs of these lights, signal lights on the sides. And then you can see the detail inside of the wheelhouse. So the captain has a little wheel for maneuvering the ship around, and he also has a couple of levers that presumably would control direction and revs of the engine. And you've also got a little panel there that would presumably be showing you radar, as well as alerts and other things that are relevant to what's going on with the ship mechanically. But they do only give you one guy to man this entire ship, so it's a little bit on the lightweight side. I mentioned there's stuff down underneath of here also, so let me go ahead and pull. Oops, accidentally taking the entire thing out. I just want to pull up this top. There we go. That's what I wanted to do. And you have an engine room. It's a completely unnecessary detail, in my opinion, but I appreciate it nonetheless. You can put one of those, you can put like your dock worker character down in there and have him doing repairs on the engine. So it just adds some extra playability that, honestly, I think is just going above and beyond what's needed for this to be a successful set as a boat and docking set. And it's not really seen very much, you know. It's a little bit hidden under there, so you really don't get to enjoy that detail that much. But I'm not going to complain about it, because it is a nice thing. Looking at the cargo area, I'm going to zoom out a little bit here. They've got these symmetrical designs, or symmetrical shapes and spaces for different containers to fit in, and they give you a range of different containers. So this is the same as like the one that was on the truck. This one here is open on the sides, and it has a little speedboat, somebody's personal transport, or maybe it's a company that's transporting this to their showroom. So you can actually take that out and use this separately. So that's just another extra little bonus thing that you get to use. It's attached by just one stud, fits in there nice and securely. They also give you this, which has some octane colored cylinders on it. these pieces are intended to be swapped between different ones. They don't give you enough of those to put them on every single container, so you have to kind of move them back and forth, or consider that to be part of the crane, really. You know, keep one of these with the crane at all times. But you can see how the modular design works here. These all will fit just into any space. It's because of the design of what they put on the bottom of them. And you can see I've turned this over sideways, and even though there we go. We're starting with the taller one, starts to fall over a little bit, but that's not too bad for how far I've turned this over. It's holding in there pretty well for something that's not actually held down with studs. And you've got room. Ultimately, you can place, let's see, how many of these things can you put in there? Four here, eight in total. So that's a lot of space, and they give you 1, 2, 3, 4 containers to place in there. So they give you extra room, and they don't give you extra parts to add more stuff. Up front, you've got another little fuel can, or maybe it just has some lubricants that are used for different things that move on the ship, including the anchor and winch. So they have a nice large anchor with a working little winch here. You can bring that up by just turning it. Turns pretty easily. This little section right here opens up also to reveal another little secret compartment where you can store some stuff. That's also something where the anchor could be kind of placed in there. It's a little bit on the large side, and you do still end up having a little bit of overlap there because it's just a little bit too large, but you can kind of place it like that to hide it away just a little bit. But I'm just going to leave it on the deck for now and bring this up, just wind this up just a little bit, just to take away a little bit of that slack. There we go. Okay, I think that pretty much takes care of what's going on with this big boat. So I'm going to move it completely off the table here and zoom out to talk about the rest of the harbor, the actual pier, the real harbor itself, after which the set is named. So nice, long, elevated platform, a little bit of pier detail under here that sets it up. So you can imagine that this space down here would all be water, and this is elevated above it. So that's very nice. Got some little chocks along the side for attaching the boat with lines to secure it to the dock. You have a couple of extra little details here, a little container you can put some tools in, a hand cart or hand truck or dolly. Over here, I'm going to leave the crane for the end. Over here, you have a little security booth, and you can use your dock worker character to be manning that security booth. And you can see they have these little barriers that come up and come down to maintain security, and also to make sure that everything is cataloged that is coming in and out of that area. You can see that these pieces, we're just playing with them for a while. These will come off pretty easily, so not the greatest design for playability there. It is nice to have these being able to come up and go down like that, but they do fall off a little bit easily. The little security room or miniature building, not going to be able to really see it much because this thing is just so large. I can't really rotate it around all the way. Wait a minute, maybe I can get through here. Yeah, okay, you can kind of see in there. There is a little computer terminal that's included in there, so that allows folks driving up, like for instance the driver of your truck could drive up and sign in there or sign out through this interesting little window detail. And then you've got the go no go signal light. There's also some more detail back here, another fuel can, another probably a gas can, or it could be considered to be a very large like a fire extinguisher type of thing. We've got a refuse container, a couple more tools here, well a shovel and stuff for maintenance, a shovel and a broom. And then there's also a little life jacket on the side of a pole and a warning sign letting you know that cars could drive off into water there. So don't drive off the edge because it is an elevated platform with water on the other side. So far, so good. And then finally, save the best for last here, I think. The crane, which has a nice wide platform, looks pretty good there. Uses the large girder support pieces. Got some lights on the sides there, and you have a rotating platform with a nice large sized cab. This opens up a little bit to give you a little bit of access to put the minifigure in there. You kind of have to tilt the whole thing back a little bit more to get more access, but you can fit them in there. That's a couple of little control levers in there. Easy to access. The design of this arm is really nice. The actual boom of the crane is a beautiful thing, and I'll show you how that works. So you've got two knobs on here. One is connected to a clear Technic gearbox here with a worm gear inside of it. And let's see if I can just get this angle in there to just fit on camera. This controls this lever right here, slowly inclining it and laying it down, which gives you, well, I'm already all the way down, but this allows you to move the entire boom up and back. And you'll see coming into the frame, you can see that the hook is able to move up really close. So you're able to move cargo in and out. Very nice, nicely done with that. I can't really take you all the way up to see the top of the boom, but you can almost see it up there. So it just angles up. And okay, let me see if I can get a little bit better angle on this as it comes down. I'll just bring it back down for you. There we go. It's slow and steady and works really well and gives you a nice long reach. And then there's another knob on the other side of this. Oops, this started to come apart just a little bit. That was my fault. This knob in the back is for controlling the actual line, the actual the string, the long string that's attached with the hook at the end of it. So I'll zoom out to get all that into frame here, and now you can see, oops, wrong one, this one. This is the one. It's the one on the side, not the one on the back. I was just using the one on the back. So you can see that you can wind that up. It just uses a pretty standard spool in there, and it helps to have a little bit of weight on this because the line is so long and it's going over a few different spots where it's being held in place. So it's good to have just a little bit of weight to make sure that this actually comes down on its own. Fresh string tends to have these little kinks in it, so it might get a little bit stuck. So that's just something that you have to live with and work through. As the string gets older, as it gets used more and more, it will become easier to go in and out. But in the meantime, it helps to have a little bit of cargo on there, and you can see that cargo goes on very nicely. Gives it a little bit of weight, and you know, holds it down, and just makes everything work much better. And then you can move things in closer to you, like so. You can move them farther away, and you can also, of course, at any point just drop them down. And if you want, you can just drop them down to the deck. You know, you don't have to have a truck there, but you will want to have a guy down there at the bottom to catch this when it comes down. It doesn't require a lot of strength, but you do need to have somebody to kind of stabilize it, stop it from spinning as it comes down, as you let it down. But pretty cool though. A lot of stuff going on, a lot of playability with this set. A very good crane, just as a crane component by itself, not even considering the fact that it's included with the set, you know, just as one of many components of the set. But it's a good crane by itself. The truck is decent. It's not a great truck, but it definitely does the job. I can't complain about it. And then the boat, the ship, is just large. It's just, I mean, like I said, I believe the longest boat hull that they've ever made. And then they give you enough minifigures for a set of this size. I think that the number of them is good, and they give you enough that have kind of a general look to them that's not too specific, that you can change their roles to suit different things that you happen to be doing at any given time. And just having the extra guy at the end, he's fishing. He doesn't have to be a fisherman. You can also turn him into a worker also, you know, when he's on duty, you can make him an actual employee. So lots of stuff going on with this set, unfortunately, out of print, out of production, But it was a great harbor set, the biggest one they've ever made in terms of size, even though the parts count doesn't really lend itself to something being so large. But they have so many pieces that are so large used in this that it just makes it a very grand set. And I'm really happy with this thing. Really very few things that I can nitpick about it, so I'm not even going to bother anymore. In all, I'm just happy to have gotten this thing. I will definitely be incorporating a lot of these elements into my Lego city once I build that up, so stay tuned for that. You can follow most of the updates on that as it starts to happen on my blog at legojang.com, and as stuff starts to become more real and gets filled in with more interesting stuff, I will of course be publishing videos about it right here on youtube.com/legojang. So I'll talk to you again soon. Bye for now.